Hello. Chief. I... Sorry, yeah, it's David Lindsay, sir. I'm sorry to call at this time, sir. But I've had a row, sir. With my wife. She's dead. I've killed her, sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. No, sir. No. Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, thank you, sir.
Dead wife. Detective Superintendent who? David Lindsay. All right. Yeah, I got it. Bye. I'm sorry, but I'm afraid you're going to have to get up, Caroline.
Lynn.
Lynn.
Caroline, not Caroline. Caroline.
I'm sorry. I meant Caroline. There's been an emergency. Thanks, love.
Were those her children?
Yeah, that was her sister came to collect them.
Right. Can I help you?
Detective Superintendent Clark, Complaints Investigation Bureau.
Detective Chief Superintendent Powers, Area Major Investigation Pool.
Ah, you seem to be double booked.
We do.
It's great.
Memory six.
Let's forget the pleasure of waking him up.
Sir, yeah, I'm sorry to wake you. Oh, were you? Yeah, I am. The problem is there's a chief superintendent from AMIP here fronting it. Yeah.
I see. Sir, would you have a word with my boss?
Hello, yes?
He was up. 2:30 in the morning, he's up.
Now, Lindsay was off duty. That means it's not CIB, it's our business. Oh, you did? And what did he say? I see. Yes. Cocky sod. Well, it seems that your boss and mine have been getting up each other's noses.
Who got the bogey?
You did. I'm off to bed. Now, look. He's one of my men, and he's a good bloke. So you won't make this any more unpleasant than it already is, will you?
We shall display the tact and sensitivity for which CIB is renowned, sir.
I was afraid of that.
Sir?
Yeah.
Did he say anything?
March the 8th, 0140 hours, he said. We had a row. She taunted me. She was shouting. I don't know what. I don't know why I did it. I went mad and killed her.
I'm sorry. Oh, God, I'm so sorry. I wish. At this point, I cautioned and arrested him.
And you are?
Detective Constable Minton, sir, exhibits officer.
What have you got?
Remains of plant bomb used to smash the TV. Mm-hmm. Coffee-stained cushion. Smashed coffee mug. Plates, cutlery from TV dinner. Two glasses. Radio Times. Coffee and bloodstains.
Anything else?
Yes. Gin bottle in washing machine.
Looks like someone had a drink problem.
Couldn't tell the difference between a fridge and a washing machine. That definitely is a drink problem.
No, sir. I think someone was hiding it in there.
Oh, really? There's also some empties in a carrier bag out the back.
We're just looking for things to do. These guys can finish up here, secure the premises. One of us should get down to Fleet Road, Nick, and let the custody sergeant, Lindsay, know what's going on. I, however, should get back to bed. So which one of you volunteers?
Mo.
We'll interview him at 11 a.m, so be sure his solicitor's been notified.
He has.
Good. How is he?
He's pretty choked.
Choked, but asleep. Eleven o'clock, okay? Night then.
Good night. How'd it go last night?
All right. I'll interview and charge him this morning. That should be it.
Good.
I wasn't sure why we'd been called in.
The police complaints authority wanted us to supervise.
How did the PCA know about it at 2 a.m?
I told them.
Morning, Clark.
Morning, sir.
David,
Bloody Clean, Mr.
Mr. Graves?
Mr. Bloody Keen Machine rang the PCA at 2 a.m. to volunteer us for that job. As if there isn't enough proper CIB stuff to deal with. And what the bloody hell is all this, anyway?
It's bloody Argyle Street guff. Questionable expenses, overtime scams, that sort of thing. There's over 100 bloody officers. Thousands of notebooks. Custody records, accident reports, duty states.
Who's doing it?
Well, whoever finishes first.
Right, Harry, the Lindsay case. Leave no stone unturned.
My thoughts entirely, Gov.
Clark? Hello? Tony?
Ah, Tony, if you have a moment, there's something I meant to ask you.
Well, we are terribly busy, so what is it?
It's a personal matter.
Would you like me to leave?
No, it's all right, Harry. Go on, sir, we have no secrets.
Well, it's apropos of your housing allowance. I needed to clarify your matrimonial positions for the records.
I am separated and will be getting divorced.
And are you cohabiting?
No, we're separated.
I mean with anyone else.
Are you sure you wouldn't?
Harry, will you stay? I am not cohabiting. None of this has any bearing on my allowance. Divorced or married, why are you asking me all this?
It was the commander. He's minded to have everyone's personal details up to date, just for the record.
Well, I'll keep you informed of any developments.
Thank you.
Don was... We were meant to be going out for dinner. To the King's. Friends of ours. But when I got home, she was... I don't know. Depressed is what I've been calling it.
What time did you get home?
About 7. Kids were fighting. She was sitting slumped in front of the TV. Sort of glazed.
You said you call it depressed. Does that mean she'd been like it a while?
Yes. I, I dealt with a case 6 or 7 months ago. A woman, a girl, was sexually assaulted, murdered, disemboweled.
Kentish Town?
Yes. It had an effect on me. We haven't had sexual relations, well, more or less, since then.
Not once?
Maybe 2 or 3 times over the last 6 months. She was very understanding at first, very patient. But then the last couple of months have been difficult. She was distant. Sometimes she would drink, get depressed. Sometimes she would get angry.
And last night?
A lot.
Tell us what happened.
When I came in, she didn't even move. The kids hadn't had their tea and we were meant to be going out for dinner.
Were you angry?
No, but I was worried about her. She was like a ghost. So I fed the kids, called the Kings to let them know we wouldn't be coming for dinner.
Did you tell them why?
No, not exactly. I said Dawn was flu-y. It was a bit embarrassing we'd cancelled before.
Same reason.
I meant to have dinner on Valentine's night.
So you fed your kids, you phoned your friends, then what?
Gave them a bath, put them to bed.
What was your wife doing?
She never left her chair all evening.
Very calm, cool-headed. A very private man.
Popular?
With the team here, he's neither popular nor unpopular. He's hard-working, meticulous, ambitious. He's a bit of a cold fish, I suppose.
Friends?
No, not really. Not here.
Crumpet man?
No, not like your boss.
Dawn had a gin bottle out beside her. It wasn't normal. She wouldn't have a bottle out when the kids were around. So I thought we might be in for a real bender.
What did you do?
I said we should talk.
What time was this?
Oh, I suppose about 8:30, 9 o'clock. Yeah, that's right. I was bringing in some glasses when the 9 o'clock news came on.
You both had a drink?
Yeah, I thought it might help if I had one as well.
And you talked?
Yeah, in fits and starts.
TV still on?
Yeah, that's right. We had all the old stuff. My mother, money. Her mother.
Other women?
No, not that. She accused me of being married to the job.
Is that true?
You know. We talked a bit, watched TV. Sometime after 10, I fixed her some dinner. But after that, I took the bottle away. I didn't want her getting drunk. Bit silly, really, but I hid it in the washing machine.
Did you taking the bottle away make her angry?
No, not any more than she'd been the rest of the evening. She got angrier later when I began to nod off. Till it showed I didn't care. Even though we've been talking all evening.
This was when?
I don't know. After midnight. I said we were crazy. We were both exhausted. We were getting nowhere. Shouldn't we get to bed?
Then?
Then she started. What's the point of going to bed with you? Shouting, screaming. She was saying we were a sham. That all I wanted to do was sit in front of the TV. She picked up this heavy plant bone and threw it at the TV, smashed the whole bloody thing. Screaming. I said something about waking the kids. She said, sort the kids. I mean, that wasn't her. She was getting wild. She threw the broken plant bowl at me, cut me. I shouted at her. I grabbed her.
I don't think I'd heard her for a while, and I suddenly realized she was saying she had a lover. Twice the man I was. A noise. A noise of a voice. And a face. A thing she was saying. And she wouldn't be quiet. She wouldn't shut up. She wouldn't stop. I wouldn't stop.
Interview terminated at 11:21.
I can just hear the judge. Oh, yes, Mr. Lindsay, I understand that wives can be terribly irritating. 6 months suspended. I'd give him 15 years and castrate him.
He'll go down.
He'll get 2.5 years maximum. Manslaughter, diminished responsibility. You have a row, you strangle your wife. You get the same sentence as you would for shoplifting.
Well, it's the same for a woman.
You mean that, don't you?
Well, of course. A woman kills her husband and aroused, the same.
No, there's one small difference. How's someone like Dawn expected to strangle a wiry wee bugger like Lindsay?
Well, she's a... Sorry, go on.
No, I don't think I should.
Go on.
A man's strength is his murder weapon. A woman would have to go into the kitchen, pick up a knife, and come back to the row. Those few seconds can mean the difference between diminished responsibility and murder. She would go down for 15 years, but because he just got on with it and strangled her, he could walk. Do you realise that? That bastard could just walk out of court.
How'd you go on with Graves? When I was acting chief super, I knew he and Harry were a team.
Fine, he was okay. Do you think it's all right for a man to strangle his wife?
No, of course it's not all right. It's not that surprising either. Where's the ketchup?
Gov. This is the disembowelment case.
Oh, it's pretty grim.
And this is interesting. It's an old case of Lindsay's from about 5 years back. Domestic murder. Man strangled his wife in marital dispute. Manslaughter, diminished responsibility, served 18 months.
Oh, Jesus.
Mo, I should think Lindsay dealt with 30 or 40 murders during his time with AMIP.
Don't you think that might have influenced him?
Possibly, but it's not our problem. I dare say the lawyers and shrinks will have a bit of fun with it.
Press Bureau being badgered, they want to put out a statement on Lindsay.
Wife found dead, suspicious circumstances, Lindsay helping with inquiries.
And we put all that out this morning.
Well, that's it.
Haven't you charged him?
Nope.
Why not?
Because if I charge him, I can't speak to him again. I think I may want to, sir.
I want you starting on the Argyle Street expenses.
No, sorry, Gov, can't do it. Got too much to do on Lindsay. Still waiting for forensics, and we've just found out it could be a copycat killing. He was involved in a similar investigation 5 years ago. His wife had told him she was having an affair.
So why wouldn't he just divorce her?
That's what we're trying to find out.
All right. But don't go tilting at windmills, Anthony. Understood.
Right. We are going to drag out this inquiry longer than West Midlands.
Bit hard on Lindsay, Guff.
Bugger Lindsay. Let him sweat.
Harry.
Harry, what was Graves' last nick before here? We've got to get some dirt on him, you know. Women, drink, masons.
You're playing with fire there, Guff.
Harry, I have always checked out my bosses, haven't you?
You bastard.
Ha,
thanks, Bill.
All right, sir. Good part of the service.
Are you busy?
No, nice and quiet. I'll be going out in a while. Is there anything you need?
No, I don't think so. Thanks. Tell you what I would like. A photograph of my kids, if possible. And my wife.
I'll have a word with Mr. Clark.
Should be a problem.
Thanks.
Do you know Clark?
No, sir.
I was just wondering if he was a bit of a stickler. I'm surprised he hasn't charged me yet.
Yeah, odd that. If he hasn't by tonight, I'll have to get a 12-hour extension from my governor. If I hear what they're up to, I'll,
I'd appreciate that, Bill. It'll go no farther than this room.
Right. Let's be on, then.
We didn't get on before he was promoted, sir. I just think it would be best for the unit if I was transferred.
I want you to suck it and see for a while, Timmy.
I'm having difficulty understanding how he came to leapfrog me. It can't be results. I have a very good record at CIB, second to none, true. Private life.
No. You work well with people you like, but not with people you don't. There's a lesson to be learnt. That's why David Graves picked you. And that's why you're going to stay here and get on with your job. Okay?
An affair?
No,
absolutely not.
How can you be sure?
Aside from the fact that it just wasn't her, when would she get the time? Breakfast, kids to school, teaching all day, dash home, cook the dinner. When? Certain jobs offer the opportunity for extramarital excursions. Teaching really isn't one of them.
How was she in terms of mood and behaviour?
Stressed. Not really with us.
Had she always been like that?
No, that was the last term or so.
Friends?
Not really. Her sister. Basically, she just lived for her husband and her children.
Doctor wasn't prepared to discuss Lindsay without his permission. She did say that Dawn was worried about her relationship with Lindsay and was withdrawn and depressed.
I got this in from the neighbours. Dawn was quiet, withdrawn, and they didn't see that much of her. Did you see the people they were meant to be having dinner with that night?
Yeah, same again. David's a saint keeping the home fires burning while his wife slips further and further into depression. It was the third time he'd had to ring and cancel dinner, short notice. It was meant to be there Valentine's Day. He phoned up to say that Dawn was too tired and then they were meant to be there a week later. Said she had a migraine. Mo, do you want to go in and get things started? I'll join you in a minute. I've got a couple of phone calls to make. Sister's in this annex next to the garage.
Still living with her mother?
Sometimes wish I was. I'll take her.
I thought you had given up.
I have.
Nail, I see.
It's me.
Oh, hello, Gov.
Busy?
Oh, yeah, I'm rushed off my feet here. Yeah, checked all the credit cards and that stuff. Nothing untoward there.
Yep.
Fleet Road rang. They want to know if you can have a photograph of his wife and kids. Mrs. Miles has got the keys and your two mates rang. The ones who are checking out graves.
They found anything?
Nothing they want to tell me.
Thanks, Harry.
But, Gov?
Yeah.
Is Mo with you?
Yep.
Is she okay?
Yeah, why?
No, nothing. No. I'll see you.
Sorry.
It may seem pretty cut and dried, but it is important, especially as he's a police officer, that the whole thing's properly investigated. We do understand that it must be very painful for you. Would you like us to leave it now and come another day?
No. It's all right. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too.
Thank you. No. Dawn wouldn't have an affair. She was so devoted to the children. Oh, God! Why?
Don't worry. We'll leave it for now.
Oh.
row. She taunted me. She was shouting. I don't know what. I don't know why I did it. I went mad and killed her. I'm sorry. Oh, God, I'm so sorry.
We were meant to be going out for dinner on Valentine's night.
Meant to have dinner with the King's Valentine's Day. Don't too tired. Should have been there a week later. Don't want to have migraine. Third dinner date, March 7th.
Sergeant, brought Mr. Lindsay's photo.
Thank you, sir. You can go through if you like.
Thanks.
He's up for a view at 2 a.m., sir.
Thanks. I'm putting in for an extension. I'll leave the glass with you.
Righto. Seems to be bearing up, mind you. I don't think he'll go topping himself or anything. Will you be charging him tomorrow, sir?
Maybe. Hello, David.
Hi, Tony.
Brought your photo.
Thanks.
Everything all right, then?
Yeah, better than I deserve. This is putting a lot of people through a lot of pain and trouble.
Oh, don't worry, mate. We'll sort it out. And I wondered if you'd give me your consent to talk to your doctor.
Yeah. Of course.
Won't be able to speak to her till the morning. Your review comes up in the middle of tonight. I'm putting in for a 12-hour extension. Is that all right with you, or will you be making representations?
That's all right.
Thanks. Good night, then.
Good night.
Good night. Good night, sir.
You're right, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
above.
What are you doing here?
Well, I did come to talk about work, but,
But?
Well, I got a bottle of wine and you're half naked and,
And this is Richard.
Hello.
Hello.
We've got a bottle of Frascati in the fridge, haven't we, darling? That'll be cold. I'll just go and get dressed.
There were signals in the interview, Lindsay's body language, but it was the calendar that really woke me up. No mention of any of the dinner dates. Thanks very much. I'm sorry to break in like this.
No problems.
No, thanks. I think it was Graves that distracted me. Lindsay's good. He's doing it very well, but he's lying his balls off.
Eureka.
You feel the same?
It's much more primitive with me. My instinct isn't necessarily that he's lying or guilty of something else. I just hate him for what he's done. If he's lying, what's he lying about?
I don't know. Maybe he was up to something. Maybe it wasn't his wife who was OTS. Maybe it was him.
What's OTS?
Unfaithful. Over the side.
Otherwise known as outtaking statements. Anyway, now we've got something to look for.
What you mean is BOS? Bit on the side. Who he was being OTS with? I mean, maybe it was just a WPC with a CID or MI5 or the DPP.
Richard, are you all right?
Well, actually, I'm not, no. I found out today I'm going to be made redundant at the end of the week. O-O-W.
Why didn't you see?
Well, I haven't really had a chance, have I?
I'm sorry, I've come at a bad time. No, I have. I'll see you tomorrow. You better make it 8. I'm sorry, Richard. Nice meeting you.
Richard.
Oh, you have?
Yeah.
Well, what's he, you know, what's
architect.
He... No, I mean, what's going on?
Don't ask me.
Gov, isn't it this? I couldn't stop the noise of her voice.
What about it?
It's not from Lindsay's statement. It's part of a statement he took from that bloke who killed his wife 5 years ago. This is Lindsay's statement. The noise of her voice and her face. And the other bloke, I couldn't stop the noise of her voice.
Jesus.
Well done, Mo.
So what now? Do we interview him again?
Nope. I want the motive. I want to know everything I can before I talk to him again. The moment he knows we're onto him, he'll shut up shop. That'll be it.
6 hours and counting.
Let's get going.
I think we should look out of town. If he was OTS, the most likely place we'd catch him is when he was away.
Yeah. Harry, what was his last job away?
Progress.
Yes, sir.
Henley. 2 months ago.
We have a case developing.
And what have you got?
I'm afraid Mo and I are just off to Henley, sir. Mo, will you get the car?
No. Sir.
Harry will take you through what we got.
Clark, the commander is adamant that we get onto the Argyle Street expenses.
And they were checked in as Mr. and Mrs. Lindsay?
Yes.
Children?
No.
Do you remember him?
Oh, yes. He was investigating that armed robbery. One of your chaps died, didn't he?
Yes.
What about the woman? This is a photo of his wife. Is this the woman who was with him?
I don't know. She kept herself to herself.
But you did see her?
I may have done, but I'm sure Anna did.
This is good. This is very good. This definitely has the feel of a dirty weekend about it.
Does it?
Yes.
Oh, can you come this way?
This is Anna.
Hello, do you remember the policeman who investigated the armed robbery?
Yes.
Do you remember what his wife looked like?
Yes, she was blonde and thin. Yes, that's her.
Damn.
I'm sorry.
No, it's not your problem. You've been very kind. Thank you. And you, sir.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Four hours and 33 minutes before I have to charge him.
Yeah.
Our only hope is the forensics come up with something.
No, drawing a blank. We're just off to talk to Dawn's mother. We should be back by one. Yeah, well, okay, I'll ask him. Harry's wife sprang the car. He wondered if it'd be all right to go home.
Oh, God. Well, I suppose nothing's happening. Harry, yeah, that's okay. It's a bit tasteless, Harry.
What did he say?
If she's written it off, I'll strangle her.
She'd surprise me a bit. Having been in one area for a long time, she's completely moved woods. It's taken me a couple of days to find her, and I'm glad I have now. Sniffing her way all the way down that trunk. Most of the hazel's down off the bushes now, onto the ground, so the squirrels haven't followed the hazel down.
They were childhood sweethearts. Doted on each other. I think she set her sights on him, and that was that.
She was a strong character.
Oh, yes. At times like this, she'd be the one to hold us all together.
And your husband?
He died when Gail was 4.
I'm sorry.
That's why Dawn had to be so strong. She was 15.
And she knew David already?
Yes. He was a great help, too. Such a kind, mannered man. I don't know how it happened. But one shouldn't be surprised. Things like this happen all the time. Life can be very hard for people.
Do you feel bitter towards David?
No. Sad. Heartbroken for the children. And Gail. And me.
Can I come through and get a cloth? Christian spilt his coke.
Please, Catherine.
Sorry.
Oh, don't worry, darling.
I think you've told us all we need to know, Mrs. Mars. We'll be off now. Gail, did either of them ask you to babysit the night it happened?
I don't remember. I don't think so, no.
I'll do it, darling.
Now, we're meant to be going out to dinner.
Well, they quite often phone me at the last minute. I'm always in.
Did they have another babysitter?
No. Dawn wouldn't leave them with anyone else but me.
Same if they went away overnight and left the children?
They never did. Dawn would never spend a night away from the children.
Oh, what about when they went to Henley?
Drove me home from babysitting. We made love in the hall the first time. It was 6 months ago. I've always loved him ever since I was a little girl. He's always loved me. We both loved Dawn. We never wanted to hurt her.
Did he ever mention killing her?
No. What are you talking about? It was a row! He wouldn't kill her, he loved her!
There's no need to go overboard, love. I mean, you're not hurt, the car or men, what's the problem?
That's not what really worries me. It's just I didn't know which was the accelerator, which was the brake. I didn't know how to turn a wheel to make it go right. Very frightening.
Yeah. Yeah, I can imagine.
So clumsy.
Well, it's old age, isn't it? Neither of us is getting any younger, are we?
Well, I don't want to get old. I don't want you to go off me and run off with some bimbo.
I'll get off. There's never been anyone else but you, you know that. No, it will be. You're serious cramping.
I mean that. Will you still love me?
When I'm 64.
Boo boo doo boo doo.
Will you still be sending me your Valentine?
Birthday greetings, bottle of wine. If I stay up till quarter to three, would you lock the door?
Girl, if you wouldn't mind waiting in here, Maureen will bring you some coffee. It's vital that Lindsay and anyone else who might talk to him doesn't know she's here.
Understand, sir.
You got an empty office for him, Borough?
Yeah, and it's the custody suite, I think, sir.
All right, thanks. No, take a full statement from her. Get 3 copies, ma'am.
Do we think she's an accomplice?
Not from what she's told us. I don't think she could lie to save her life.
No, but she has given us proof that Lindsay's lied, and she's given us a motive for premeditated murder.
No, I wonder if she has.
He kills Dawn, Gail gets the kids. He gets Gail.
You are joking. After he's killed her sister, she'd run a mile.
No. He has visiting rights to the children. She has always been in love with him. She would forgive him in time. She would take him back.
Less than 2 hours to go. I don't have time to get back to CIB. I'll get Harry to bring all the stuff up with
him. Yeah, well, remember, he'll be coming from home.
Oh, shit. And he's gonna have to go to the post-mortem. Mm. We're all tied up. This is a bloody show. I hear you've got an empty office spare.
Yes, sir. They're here, sir.
Okay, Mo, it's 1:10. Try and get a statement out of her by 2. I know, try.
Is Harry not here yet? I've sent her home. I got everything you wanted.
Anything new?
No.
Oh, thank God. What you got?
Death by strangulation. About the time that Lindsay said. Blood alcohol levels consistent with 2 or 3 small gins, but not with someone who'd been drinking heavily over recent days.
Anything else?
Yeah. She had a Dutch cabin.
Semen?
No.
Oh, for Christ's sake. We're going round in circles. Does that mean she did have a lover? She was going to see him later that night? Harry, all the stuff from CIB, Lindsay's first interview, the calendar, all that.
It's on its way. Oh,
this is a bloody joke. I haven't got any papers, and I don't have any time. Anything useful?
That was someone called Tim who says he has discovered that Graves is a member of the Ealing, Gilbert and Sullivan Society.
Is this the breakthrough we have all been waiting for?
Harry!
Oh, yeah, God, I forgot. Graves wishes you good luck.
Does he?
All right, Gov, let's have a look what we got. Calendar. No entries for the 3 meals, but entries for just about every other event in their lives. Alcohol. Forensics say she'd been drinking, but not as heavily as Lindsay suggested. And we've got a motive. He was screwing his wife's kid sister.
Yeah.
Anything else? Well, it's all circumstantial, isn't it? None of this proves that Lindsay premeditatedly planned his wife's death. I mean, it might convince us, but it's not going to get a conviction, is it? Unless we get a confession out of him, we got sod all.
Thank you, Harry.
Gov? The cap. The Dutch cap.
I think they're ready to charge you now, sir.
Sir?
Sir?
I brought your papers.
Oh, thank you. Remember, sir, you've got just under 30 minutes. He has to be charged before 1447.
Thank you, Sergeant. Mo, if you don't mind, I think I'll do this with Harry.
I do mind, sir.
You're too wound up. You could be a liability. The moment he sniffs we're onto him, he'll clam up.
Gov, I am okay. All right.
All right, but keep calm. He's got to think we're on his side.
Hello, David. Sorry to drag you back. As you can imagine, this had a bit of a profile with the powers that be, press.
I understand.
Would you like tea, coffee?
Coffee, please.
Harry, would you grab the sergeant? Recorded interview, March 9th, 14:20 hours, Fleet Road Police Station. I'm Detective Superintendent Anthony Clark. Also present, Detective Sergeant Maureen Connell. Will you identify yourself, please?
David Lindsay.
And?
David Thomas.
David Thomas, Mr. Lindsay's solicitor. You don't have to say anything unless you wish to do so, but what you say may be given in evidence. Right, first, I would like to put on record our thanks to Detective Superintendent Lindsay for allowing a 12-hour extension to his detention without making representations.
All right, let's take them in order. David, to the best of your knowledge, did you or Dawn have any financial worries?
No. The domestic budget, balancing the mortgage and so on, is always a trial, but no. To be honest, Dawn's family, her mother, I mean, has... Well, she's not rich, like, rich, but she would bail us out if it got too tight.
Has she done that in the past?
Not exactly. If we are getting a new car, she'll maybe chuck in £1,000 so we can get a slightly better one. That sort of thing.
So you don't owe her or anyone else any money?
No.
All right. What's that one? Sorry, this is a little more intimate. Had you had sexual relations recently with Dawn?
The last time would have been a couple of weeks ago.
Initiated by whom?
Me, I believe. I'd been feeling slightly warmer towards Dawn, but she was still very tense. Very unhappy.
I understand. You were therefore the more affectionate of the two of you at this time.
I was.
When would you say was the last time Dawn initiated or tried to initiate sexual intercourse?
Weeks, maybe months ago.
Mm-hmm. I believe you said during the first interview that your wife had taunted you about taking a lover. Having had time to reflect, do you still believe there was no lover?
Yes, I still feel it unlikely that Dawn had a lover.
So we can safely say that as neither of you had any sexual involvement with any other person, that this was a personal, emotional breakdown triggered by your experiences at the Kentish Town murder?
Yes.
Right. Were you adversely affected by any other murders you've investigated?
Well, they all have an effect, I suppose.
Well, anything in particular come to mind?
No.
All right. Any idea how many murders you've dealt with?
Maybe 40. I don't know.
Okay, right. What sort of contraception did you and Dawn use?
The cap. The Dutch cap.
Where did your wife keep the cap?
In a dressing table, I think.
In a drawer?
Yes.
How much was Dawn drinking in the last few weeks?
Superintendent's coffee, sir.
Custody sergeant has brought coffee for Superintendent Lindsay. Superintendent, I asked you how much you would say your wife was drinking recently.
It varied. The last few days she'd cut back. I think that may have been why she was so tense.
So tense, Dawn never left her seat all evening?
No.
To go to the toilet?
Oh, yes. Maybe.
But not to go upstairs?
No.
Right. Now, we've been talking to your sister-in-law, Gail. She said she wasn't booked to babysit that night you killed Dawn. Night you were meant to be going to the King's for dinner.
Dawn was meant to book her. She probably forgot.
Maybe that was because she hadn't marked it down in her diary. She did know about the dinner?
Oh, yes, of course. She must have forgot to put it in her diary.
On her diary. All diary in the kitchen. There's also no mention on that diary or calendar, whatever. Of the other two dinners you were meant to be having with the Kings, any idea why?
Forgetfulness.
But she did know about the dinner dates.
Oh, yes.
Did Gail once have a boyfriend called Darren?
I'm not sure I understand the point of the question.
He brought her home one night on his motorbike when you and Dawn were there. You told him to leave her alone or you'd break his legs. Is that right?
No comment.
Fair enough. Just trying to see if you feel you're a passionate, protective man. All right, I'll just read this out. I couldn't stop the noise. I couldn't stop the noise of her voice. You heard that before?
Yes.
When?
I said it. When I made that statement the day after. The day I killed Dawn. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for what I've done.
No. No, David, you didn't say it. Was actually said to you in a statement by Richard Sabatovsky 5 years ago. I just wondered if you recognized it. Detective Superintendent Lindsay is whispering to his solicitor.
I have nothing further to say at this time.
I have the legal duty to give you the opportunity to hear some of the evidence that weighs against you. Perhaps it will give you the chance to offer us some simple explanations for certain matters. I've handed Detective Superintendent Lindsay a copy of a statement given to us by Gail Miles at Fleet Road Police Station earlier today. As you decline to pick it up, I will read the relevant piece or pieces. We first made love on the 28th of August. David drove me home. I'd been babysitting. We sat in the car and talked. We knew what was going on, but we didn't want it to happen. I got out of the car, but he didn't drive away. He got out too. I went inside. He followed. We made love there in the hall. He said it would be all right. I'm sorry. Dawn, I'm sorry. There seems to be a contradiction. Gail says you and she were having a passionate love affair. She refers here to several occasions of lovemaking during a period when you say you were having sex with nobody, not even your wife. Is there a simple explanation? Dawn always thought of you as Gail's surrogate father, didn't she? In fact, in a way, I think Gail has always seen you as a father figure. Would you say that was fair? You're 13 years older than her. When you first met her, she was 4 years old. You were 17. We have reason to believe that that last night with Dawn was not as chilly and relentlessly antagonistic as you've suggested. We believe, and we hope you can help us here, we believe that when you came home early that night and put the children to bed, Dawn was thrilled. Dawn had endured some very lonely months. That night, however, you were helpful. You made her dinner, you brought her a drink, were kind. Do you know what she did? She put a cap in for you. Detective Superintendent Lindsay declines to pick up the forensic report. The report shows, from the breakdown of spermicidal cream, that the cap had been fitted 20 to 30 minutes before death. Can you explain that? Because it seems to me that Dawn, this woman you say was drinking heavily, this woman you say was ignoring her kids, this woman you say was taunting you with her lover, that this woman, Dawn, your wife and the mother of your children, wanted to make love with you that night.
I have no further comment to make at this time.
It's all right, my horse.